you know, one of the aspects that always kind of interests me is he talks about, like, they don't have, you know, we've got a penny and a half, so our options are limited. And we're talking about an extremely powerful arcanist. He's traveling around by himself. He doesn't have any money. He doesn't have a lot of food, pretty much out of food. And
he's eating oats with the mules, yeah, or the jackasses. Donkeys,
yeah. And he's in a part of the world that probably hasn't seen an arcanist in 50 years. Why is he there?
It's a very good question. Hmm. Yeah, what's he doing?
Why the fuck would he go there?
Yeah, why is he there of all places with all these things that he offers, with all of his abilities? He brews. There's tons of towns he could be in and make money.
And he just happens to show up at this town, runs into Kvothe, and, you know, wheedles his way into traveling with Kvothe's troop. So that always, you know, that always raises like a flag in my head with Abenthy, is like, is he there purpose? Did he go purposefully to that town? Is he trying to meet up with Kvothe's troop? You know, maybe he could be someone that is like working for the Emir, and they know that these guys have been, you know, that his parents have been singing songs about the Chandrian, and so maybe that they tracked them down, and he's traveling with them to get information or for some kind of purpose. I don't know exactly, you know, what he's doing, or it could be that he's there specifically to get close to that family and help Kvothe and train him.
Now that you mention it, yes, it seems quite, well, what really seems suspicious when he dips out, obviously, but yeah, no, it's a very good point. Like, he has all these abilities, he has all these things that he's able to do, he has all this knowledge, and he's choosing to supply face paint to a traveling troupe. That's his utility at this point that he can offer. Yeah, it's really interesting. It's really quite interesting that's how he's fallen. It feels like this would be someone with all these abilities. He's deciding to check himself down many, many levels to this state.
Well, is a quick read through, you wouldn't notice it. I mean, I didn't. He's out of food. He's out of money. He takes the job that he can get. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
No, yeah, no. Yeah, I mean, my first read through, I hadn't considered it. I've always considered I've always had some suspicion, but it's not with what Dan just described. It's more when he ends up leaving and what happens after that causes you to question a bit. But yeah, I mean, and this is a very valid question that Dan's bringing up. When you think all of these things he's able to do, I mean, he can make money in towns. There's so much that he can supply, yet he's just traveling with no money. So yeah, I mean, you have to. It does beg the question. Not on like you said, on a first read through, you're just accepting what's being given to you. You know what I mean? And you're rolling with it, and you like the guy. So there's, you know, you're not really suspicious of everything that you read. At least I'm not. You know.
And he's a great, like, his Kvothe's dad says, like, he's the best brewer that he's ever found. Like, I mean, this dude could just go brew. Be a brewer in a nice town and make some money. Why is he traveling the roads like that with no money, with no food, with all that talent, and to a town that hasn't seen an Arcanist in 50 years, that is hostile, you know, to Arcanist, without knowing what happened preceding all this? It seems odd for him to be there. And anytime there's something that odd, it raises questions in my mind about what's the real thing going on here. So I don't know. Yeah, it could,
that's really interesting.
Could just be, you know, there could be reasonable explanation or, you know, he just happened to be there for whatever reason. And he just happened to get involved with the crew, and, you know, he ended up like Kvothe, and he trained him, and then he, you know, meets that lady in, you know, the lady whose husband had died, the widow, mm-hmm. Who was a brewer. Mm-hmm. He meets her when they go into that town. So he leaves the group right before the Chandrians show up and kill everybody. All that could be the case, that it's just coincidences, but it's a lot of coincidences. Mm-hmm. And the whole entire section with him is filled with nothing but coincidences.
Well, and especially
makes you question it.
Well, and especially if we're not told why he's where he is, why he has so little money. We're not told why. We're just told the what is. But yeah, it does beg the question for sure. And additional read throughs. I got a little thing. So you had mentioned you were talking about Abenthy. You know, why is he here? That type of thing. And there was something that kind of it's very very subtle. But they're talking about Abenthy and him, you know, they're talking about their relationship and how they're sort of, you know, starting to get to know each other and how Abenthy or Kavoth is starting to ask him more and more questions. And there's a point where he's asking him about the university, asks if they teach acting at the university. Abenthy just shakes his head, slightly amused by the questions. They teach many things, but not that. And he says he looked over at Abenthy and saw him watching Kavoth. His eyes danced. And then, could you teach me some of those other things? Now, it's subtle, but it seemed to me that Abenthy, I know, again, it's a subtle line, but just before those lines, Abenthy seemed to be listening as well in an offhand way. It made me feel like Abenthy was waiting for him to ask. You know what I'm saying? Like just the suggestion mm-hmm. that he was watching me. Like, I looked over to Abenthy and saw him watching me. He doesn't really have a reason for Abenthy. Like, there isn't really a reason for Abenthy to be watching him. They're just talking. But watching him with his eye, and his eyes danced, knowing that question's coming. That suggests that he knows that question's coming. Can you teach me some of those things? And it's like, I got him. I mean, I don't know. It feels like that's what that line said to this time through.
Yeah, it could be. Are you
inferring that Abenthy might be a vampire, Tim? Like, he's got to be invited to speak on things and to...
No, not at all. Not at all am I going the vampire route. And mainly the reason...
I just thought that might be your theory.
The reason why I'm not going the vampire route is there is not a single shred to suggest that. Outside of what you just said.
Yeah, but just you can't disprove it, though. You can't disprove it.
That's right.
So it just ends up becoming an Anne Rice novel in book three?
Yeah. Abenthy's a vampire, and Den is a werewolf, and he's in love with a werewolf, and Abenthy and her fight and kill each other.
So
he's very depressed about it.
So after the first two books are so successful, but he doesn't have a TV show or a movie yet, he just goes, all right, well, let's just do the... Now I can't think of the reference, man.
Well, Twilight.
Yeah, the Twilight. Yeah, let's just go the Twilight route.
Yeah.
How do I cash in on this?
Kavoth, the girl caught in the middle between the vampire and the werewolf fighting over him.
You know what? That makes me so excited for book three. I was on the fence about it, even finishing the podcast, but now I'm in, guys, 100%.
Yeah, I've figured out a couple things. We got the Mario Brothers theory and the Twilight theory in this episode. So got a couple things figured out. Did a lot of good work here. But yeah, no, I do. I could totally see that he was, you know, kind of leading Kavoth without, you know, leading Kavoth into wanting to be taught, into asking for it.
Yeah, it's funny because it's one of those things, because we're going back through these books and now, you know, I have more of a focus of everything matters. That line definitely had not jumped out at me before, but now it most definitely did. And it does give that feeling of yes, he's leading him in. And it does, I'm now getting to the point, I'm starting to slowly be convinced that Abenthy does seem to be part of maybe the Emir, or, you know, there's a plan here. It seems like there's a plan here that's playing out, and Abenthy was placed here for a reason. you know, and he's so pivotal. I mean, he's so important to Kavoth's existence and his, you know, his development. That it's to put it on happenstance is, yeah, that's a tough one.
It just because of him dipping in and dipping out and all that kind of stuff, like it seems, it would just, to put all those coincidences together, it just seemed very un-Rothfuss, not like him. Usually if something, you know, makes you a little uneasy and raises questions, it's usually for a reason. It's usually there's something there.